which is new and exciting, and it's going to be great. So first, just want to make sure that every time I talk, I want all eyes on me. And when I ask something or you want to share something, raise your hand before. So now, I'm going to do a couple of things, and I want you all to watch me while I do them, and then raise your hand and tell me what I'm doing.
Mystery bolt that comes from like what you touch to the light.
So what did I do to make the lights turn off?
You, Dion.
What did I flip?
That's
right. Okay. So now I'm gonna do one more thing. What just happened? Too deep. What caused it to fall?
Right hand.
My hands caused it. Okay, so now one more thing, and it doesn't involve me doing anything like that. So we had things put up on the class meeting list. What caused that to happen? There's a couple things that caused that to happen, but Naomi.
Behavior.
Isaiah? Yeah, people talking? Well, so those are all great examples, but you're probably like, okay, this Inez is turning the lights off, she's throwing things off the table, what are these things having to do with anything? So, we are going to be talking about cause and effect, which I know that you guys all have talked about before, but what we're going to be doing with it today is going to be looking at how it takes place in stories, because cause and effect, just like problem and solution, is what makes up a story. That's how we know what's happening in the story, that's how things get exciting, and that's what gets the ball rolling, right? So, we're just going to review on a little bit of cause and effect. So we are going to look at this poster. So, who can tell me? Thank you.
You can go as man.
This is Asher. And he's super fast and he's beautiful and
how much he calls for a dog?
Well, I I have a little story about him. So sometimes I like to take him on walks. And one day, he's walking with me, and he just bolts down the street when I have the leash. So obviously, he was no longer with me because I can't run as fast as him. And he ran because he saw a squirrel.
Did he come back?
So Asher saw a squirrel, and he ran. So who? I want you to turn and talk to your neighbors and tell me what the cause and what the effect is. Is
Asher saw a squirrel? Dull.
until the cow started crying. A cow? Crying? Yeah, you see, a haystack fell on her. But a haystack doesn't just fall over.
Hey,
does if a farmer crashes into it with his tractor. Oh, come on. A farmer wouldn't do that. He would if he were too busy yelling at the pigs to get off the school bus. What were the pigs doing on the school bus? Eating our lunches. Why were they eating your lunches? Because we threw their corn at each other and they didn't have anything else to eat. Well, that makes sense, but why were you throwing corn? Because we ran out of eggs. Out of eggs? Why were you throwing eggs? Because of the boa constrictor. The boa constrictor? Yeah, Jimmy's pet boa constrictor. Why was Jimmy's pet boa constrictor what was it doing at the farm?
In the farm.
Oh, he brought it to meet all the farm animals. But the chickens didn't like it. I wouldn't like it either, honestly. You mean he took it into the hen house? Yeah. And the chickens started squawking and flying around. Go on. What happened? Well, one hen got excited and laid an egg, and it landed on Jenny's head. The hen? No, the egg. And it broke, yucky, all over her hair. What did she do? She got mad because she thought Tommy threw it, so she threw one at him. What did Tommy do? Oh, he ducked and the egg hit Mary Ann in the face. Yikes.
Mary Jane.
So she threw one at Jenny, but she missed and it hit Jimmy, who dropped his boa constrictor.
Oh my God.
Oh, I know. And the next thing you knew, everyone was throwing eggs, right? Right. And when you ran out of eggs, you threw the pigs corn, right? Right again. Well, what finally stopped it? Well, we heard the farmer's wife screaming. Why was she screaming?
The bus?
We never found out because Mrs. Stanley made us get on the bus. And we sort of left in a hurry without the boa constrictor.
What? In what world?
Yeah, they left the boa constrictor.
What's a boa constrictor?
Yeah, she was surprised by that?
He's not gonna do anything at all. Yeah,
I bet Jimmy was sad because he left his pet boa constrictor. Oh, not really. We left in such a hurry that one of the pigs didn't get off the bus. So now he's got a pet pig. Boy, that sounds like an exciting trip. Yeah, I suppose. If you're the kid that's kind of into class trips to the farm. Looks like they brought him on a NASCAR.
NASCAR.
We're
late.
It's
a box.
A box car. And then it ends by showing the farmer and his wife, and you see the little boa constrictor all curled up. Fireplace.
So
I guess it wasn't so bad after all.
Or do they know that this is the boa
constrictor? So did we see any causes and effects in there?
Yeah.
A ton. Okay, so I want everybody to get up and go back to our seats because we're gonna be looking at the chart and filling it out.
Go back to our seat.
Chart and pies.
Got it?
Why am I writing chart? examples, because I know there's more than that, but we're just going to look at five. We could go all day. All right, so who can think of an effect or a cause or book that we saw? Hi, Mary. She threw an egg at somebody, right?
Because so, what looks.
So her name was Jenny. So Jenny had an egg dropped on her head. So, but what was the effect? Yeah, they started throwing eggs, but what did this make her do?
She got
she threw an egg.
I know, it was just everybody was missing and eggs were going everywhere.
And it makes think everybody's heart.
Okay, so she
that's good breakfast.
Threw an egg at someone else.
No, somebody ducked and didn't eat somebody.
So did we see any other ones? Maybe not with the eggs, because those ones are just egg thrown. Somebody else gets the egg thrown. The cow is crying. So, would that be the cause or the effect of something?
The
effect. So, the cow is crying. Now, who can tell me why the cow is crying? Justin. Because the hay stack was dropped on her.
That makes sense.
I mean, it probably could have been the head too. Okay. Any other ones we can think of? Shaija?
Because the reason the hay fell on the cow was because the cow was trying to ran into the hay.
Okay, so where would that go? Would we put the tractor hit the hay in the cause or the effect? When we talk all at the same time. What if you have a question. Quickly. So the farmer hit the haystack would have been the effect. You know, know why? Because the cause of him hitting the haystack was...
Because the pigs were hitting the bus. The pigs on the bus.
Because the pigs were on the bus.
That would be the cause of the haystack falling over the girl.
So do you see why we look at...
It's a these are only a few examples. There were a ton in the book, but do you see how important cause and effect is within a story?
It can be harm. It can be harm.
Well, would there be any story without all of these things that we've written in more?
Yes.
No, there would be no story. This book would not exist.
What? How does it have harm?
I know.
Shut up.
Whoa.
He was talking about
him.
The book.
Oh, sorry.
So, this book would be nothing without all the causes and effects we saw. Now, we're going to be doing something a little interesting, but I need y'all all to pay close attention or else you're going to have absolutely no idea what to do. So, what we'll be doing is we're going to be pairing up in partners. Y'all can pair partners and there might be two groups of three, okay? Once you get in your partners, I'm going to need you to get around the perimeter of the room. But don't get up yet because I have to tell you what you and your partner are going to do or else you're not going to know what to do. So, each pair of partners will be getting a bright green envelope.